Jai Hind one and all. The topic we are going to take today is electric field lines. An electric field line as a path, straight or curved in electric field when a charge is suspended freely in a 2D or 3D coordinate system such that tangent to it at any point gives the direction of electric field intensity at that point, which means if we freely suspend a charge in two-dimensional or three-dimensional coordinate system, the trajectory followed by it will be called as electric field lines, and the tangent drawn on it gives the direction of electric field intensity at that point. Now, if we take an isolated positive charge, then we can see that the electric field lines are radially outward, which is shown by the arrowheads outward. Whereas if we take the isolated negative charge, the electric field lines are radially inward, which is just opposite of the positive one. Now, if we take the example of a combination of charge, that is positive charge and negative charge, then the electric field lines will always start from positive charge and end up at the negative charge. Whereas these electric field lines are radially inward. And these electric field lines are radially outward. However, if we take the combination of charges, like charges, that may be two positive charges or two negative charges, the electric field lines are repulsive in nature. As you can see, since it is positive, they are radially outward. As you can see, radially outward, radially outward. Even if the charges taken are negative, then they will be radially inward. In the case of positive, it will be radially outward. In the case of negative, it will be radially inward. And we know they are repulsive in nature. Now, suppose we are having a long rod having the positive charges on it. As you can see, we will be having the uniform electric field. And again, it will be radially outward, radially outward. Radial means over here is normally outward, the rod, this positive charge carrying rod. Okay. Now, let's go to the properties of electric field lines. The first point we are having, electric field lines are continuous curves. They start from a positively charged body and end at a negatively charged body. So, from the example, as the example we have seen over here, they have started from the positive charge body and end at the negative charge body. So, the first point explains that the electrostatic field lines are continuous. They are continuous, but they are not closed loops because they will start from positive and end at negative. Whereas the closed loop means that again they will start from negative and ends up at the positive. But this will never happen. For the second point, no two electric field lines of force can intersect each other. The electric field lines of force will never intersect each other. Why? For example, if the electric field lines of force intersected each other, then at the point of intersection, we will have the tangents in two different directions, which will not be possible. The third point, the electric field lines are always normal to the surface of the conductor. This we have already seen in this example. In this example, as you can see, that the electric field lines from isolated positive charge is normally outward for the positive and normally inward for a negative. This is the explanation of the third point. We are going to the fourth point. Electric field lines passes through the dielectric. As we know that the air and vacuum both acts as an insulator, which is a dielectric, and dielectric do have the property of producing induced charges without being get conducted. Hence, in this example, as you can see, the electric field lines are passing through the air or vacuum. The last point, the electric field lines contract longitudinally on account of attraction between unlike charges. Suppose we have two different charges, one positive and negative. They will try to attract each other, and this is what the point explains, that they will contract longitudinally. The magnitude of the field is represented by the density of field lines. That means the density is higher then the electric field intensity will be higher and electric field lines will be higher. And if the electric field lines are crossing away from the charge, then the number of electric field lines will be lower, and hence the density will get lower, the magnitude of the density will get lower.